Okay, so welcome back in the second session. And so before, you know, in the first session, we were discussing about the use of have to and has to and must, and also how they both are different. We will be discussing more about it in this session. So let me read out those examples, some of the examples which you can see on my screen. Okay, one thing which is noteworthy for all of you, that have to is a modal verb that can be used with, you know, for future as well. For example, we use do, don't, and doesn't, and you know, has for talking about the present obligations, for talking about something that is compulsory, that is essential, that is necessary for you to do, or that is the obligation on you to do it in the present time. We can also use it with future by using will. For example, I will have to give a presentation tomorrow. I will have to give a presentation tomorrow. Or you can say that my, you know, my company has, or my boss has, or the manager of my company has selected me for giving the presentation in the board meeting. So I will have to give a presentation next week. All right. So if you are using will with have to, it will become, you know, you can use it for future. It will be used for future. If you are using it for with I, we, you, and they, then you can use have to. Like, you know, I have to. Okay, I have to work hard for, you know, for my entry test in the medical college, and you have to listen to your parents, or you have to follow the rules, or you have to follow the instructions given by the teacher. All right. But if we are using it with for, you know, he, she, or with a name, then you can say that, you know, Sarah has to stay, or has to work late because, you know, her company is going to wind up, and or the company is, you know, you can say that doing audit or is going to wind up. So she has to work late. All right. He has to work late. Okay. So this is like, as I told you before, that we treat have to as the same way as we treat simple present tense. We use have to for future as well when we add will with it. All right. And for past, we use had to. All right. Yesterday, you know, it was raining. It was raining cats and dogs yesterday morning. But I had to go to office because my manager called me to report as we had an important meeting scheduled, right? So you can see that we always learn grammar with and the language and understand modal verbs when we add some situations with it. As I gave you an example that, you know, yesterday it was raining, cats and dogs, but I had to go to office. It means that, you know, it was an obligation. It was important for you to go to office. All right. Now, let's see. There are some examples of questions and negative sentences on the screen. What do I have to do to get a new driving license? Not what have I to do. All right. So you can't treat have as a modal verb here. You will treat have as the main verb. Right. Have to is a phrase that will come together. And after have to, we need to use first form of the verb. Karen doesn't have to work Saturdays. All right. Karen doesn't have to work Saturdays. So simply has to. And what will be the negative of has to? Doesn't have to. Did you have to wait a long time for a bus? No, only 10 minutes. All right. So when you are making the negative in questions with had, use did. As we use, you know, in the past simple tense, simple past tense, what we use did. Like, did you eat, you know, did you eat your breakfast in the morning, or did you go to, you know, university yesterday? So the same way we make questions and negatives with did. You can say I'll have to, or I'm going to have to, or I might have to, or I may have to as well. All right. I'll have to. I've already discussed with you. I'm going to have to. These are, you know, these are not so usable, but yes, there is a kind of, you know, some exposure has been given to you. I'm going to have to buy a new one. All right, they can't repair my computer, so I'll have to buy a new one. This is the better sentence. It is a balanced sentence. All right, I'll have to buy a new one because there is no option. Your computer can't be repaired. Okay, now I'm going to have to buy a new one. You can use instead of this as well. There's no harm in it. Let's come to this. You know, must is similar to have to. You can say, all right, but in what situations it is similar and in what it is not, let's learn about it. You can use must or have to when you give your own opinion. For example, to say what you think is necessary or to recommend someone to do something. Okay, so this is the definition for both. You can use must or have to when you think that something is necessary and it is your own opinion. It is your opinion to do something. All right. I haven't spoken to Sue for ages. I must phone her or I have to phone her. I say this is necessary. You are saying you think that it is necessary. Okay. Now, Mark is really a nice person. You must meet him or you have to meet him. It means what you are doing, you are recommending. When you recommend something. Now, we use have to, not usually must, to say what someone is obliged to do. This is a fact, not the speaker's own opinion. All right. Now, please try to understand the difference. When you are talking about, you know, when you are sharing your opinion, all right, when we talk about the speaker's opinion, we can use both, either must or have to. But when we talk about that this is someone is obliged to do, when something is a fact, not the opinion, all right, then we use have to, not must. Like, I have to work from 8:30 to 5:30 every day. It is a fact, not an opinion, all right. Jen has to travel a lot for her work. This is a fact because maybe she's working somewhere which involves a lot of traveling, which requires a lot of traveling, okay. I have to, okay, we have that. But we use must in written rules and instructions. For example, applications for the job must be received by 18th May or seat belt must be worn. All right. It means when we talk about rules and instructions and regulations, we use must. We use had to, not must, to talk about past. We never use must for past. We always use had to. So we can say that what can be used instead of must when we are talking about past. So the answer is had to. I went to the meeting yesterday, but I had to leave early. Not I must. I am giving you an example. For example, okay. All right. I had to pay my speeding. I had to pay my speeding ticket yesterday. Like, you must complete the essay by Friday, and we have to complete the essay by Friday. All right, these two are sentences in which we are using must and have to, the same sentence. But when you are saying you must complete the essay by Friday, it means this obligation is coming from the teacher. When you say we have to complete the essay by Friday, it means that this instruction, like the teacher has given, this is an obligation on you, which has been given to you by the teacher. And the teacher is giving the students an obligation in the first sentence, like you must. And the second one, we have to complete the essay. It means that this is an obligation which is from the teacher's side. Okay, we mustn't and don't have to are completely different. Okay, when we talk about the negative sentences, you mustn't do something. All right, you must keep this a secret. You mustn't tell anyone. It means don't tell anyone. I promised I would be on time. I mustn't be late. It means I must be on time. All right. So must is a stronger obligation and have to is little, lenient. I mean, if you do something or if you don't do something, that is, it is fine. For example, you must not drink that here. All right. It means it is forbidden to drink. It is not allowed. It is a rule that you can't drink, that you mustn't drink here. But if you say you don't have to drink that, it means that it is an obligation. You don't need to drink in this place, but you can if you want to. All right. So what we understand by this that mustn't and must is more stronger. It is stronger, is a strong obligation as compared to have to. Next, we can use have to get to, you know, have got to instead of have to. You can say, I've got to work tomorrow. And you may have heard this expression a lot of times that, you know, I have to, I have got to work tomorrow, or I have to work tomorrow. Both are same. You can either use have got to or have to. They both are same, no difference. But you are getting this to, you know, getting to know this, because when you see somewhere it is written that way or it is spoken that way, so you don't get confused that these are two different expressions. No, they are the same expression. Okay. So do you have any
questions
so far?
In yes. American English, we use I have got to work tomorrow. Is it used in American English?
No, it is used in British English. Okay. I've got to work. It is British.
I have to work.
All right. And have to work is American, and have got to. All right. I've got to go. I've got to go is British. All right. Because American English and British English, there are some grammatical differences. Yes, please.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Second one is, ma'am, can we use must in past form? For example, you must have work hard by leaps and bounds for getting admission medical university.
Yeah. All right. So must have and past participle is possible. All right. Must
third
have in
form,
past participle. Yes, exactly. Like should have. We use, you know, have and past participle with all modal verbs. You can have, you could, you could have, you must have, you know, and you may have. All right. So we use have and past participle for past, to talk about past actions. All right. Past possibilities. So we will come
to it. Second one is, yes. Mm-hmm. Second one is you must have had a pen during exams.
You must have had
a pen during exams.
Yes.
With you.
Exam. Yes. You must. No. I mean, you're talking about past. All right. So this is the rule. I mean,
sure, ma'am. Sure, ma'am.
When you are saying you must have a pen during exam. All right. It means that you are talking about present, and you are talking.
Present. Yes, ma'am. Present.
You know, it is an instruction that you are giving it to other that, you know, you must have a pen with you during exam. Not only one. I mean, you should, you must have, you know, at least two pens with you when you are, you know, taking your exam. All right.
Sure.
So that you can save your time and hassle. I mean, you don't have to face the trouble in the exam when you must have two pens with you. All right. So this is an instruction that you are giving. This is something that you can say an obligation as well. This is an instruction that you are giving to someone, right? In the past, how we use in past, it has a different usage. So when we will come to past, then I'll explain you, okay? So now we are going to go for the exercises. So let's go for exercises, and I would like to do the exercise. Let us do the exercise number 2, because it has, you know, the verbs given to you. All right, so in the box, you will see that there are verbs given to you, and as well as these are the sentences. So let's see how you do it. Okay. So sentence number 1, all right, is already done. I'm not working tomorrow, so I don't have to get up early. All right. It means that maybe tomorrow is off, so you don't have to go to work. All right. Now, second, you can please write, you can unmute yourself and tell me the answers, as well as you can write your responses in the chat box. It will be appreciated. Okay. All right. So sentence number 2. Let me just. Okay. Steve didn't know how to change the setting on his phone. Okay. The second one is also done. I had to show him. Right. So you see that in the previous class, I told you that you must have to. You must focus on the sentence agreement. The first one is in past. The second one has to be in past. It's not possible that one is in other, you know, tense and the other one is entirely different. That doesn't make an agreement. Okay. Excuse me a moment. I blank a phone.
Have to.
Okay. So what do you think is number 3? I have to.
I have to.
Make a call. Make a call.
I have to a phone call.
I have to make a phone call.
Okay. I have to make a. Wait a minute.
A phone call.
Okay. Good. those who are writing in the, okay, Misbah has written have to make. Okay, so excuse me a moment. I have to make a phone call. I want to be long. Correct. Good. Now, next, you can let me know later. You can let me know later what you want to do. All right. So number four, or please you can pick the words from the box. All right. This box, ask, decide, drive. So these verbs and hints are already given to you. Okay. So number four, can you please write in the chat box? Okay. Excuse me. No, you can let me know later what you want to do. You can let me know later. Please, can you just focus on this phrase and this sentence? You can let me know later. Baad mein bata dena what you want to do.
No, ma'am.
Okay. First of all, like I'm telling you, right? Okay, I'm telling you. You know, Asad, like for example, ke.
Yes.
Okay, you can let me know this later on. You know, you can tell me this later. You don't want to do it now. You. बाद में बता देना अभी नहीं बताना अभी क्या करने की जरूरत नहीं है. Alright. So which word do you think is suitable? You don't have to.
Ask.
No. Like I'm saving you from. You know. You can say that you know. You can let me know later what you want to do. The sentence has to be negative. Okay, this is the hint I'm giving you. All right, make a negative with have to. You don't or doesn't?
You don't.
Okay, you don't have to. And the verb is decide. You don't have to decide now. Okay, so yes. now you see that this sentence, this situation is making a sense that you can let me know later. You don't, you know, what you want to do. You can let me know later what you want to do. You don't have to decide now. Okay? Abhi bhi faisla karna, baad mein bata dena. You're getting me? Okay. Number five. I couldn't find the street I wanted. Okay. I couldn't find the street I wanted. I blank somebody for directions.
I have to ask somebody for directions.
Okay. See, I want you to focus on, couldn't find the street. Okay. I couldn't find the street I wanted, so I have to or I had to? I had to ask.
I have to ask.
Had to ask.
I had to ask. Ariba, yes. Correct. Those boys who are answering had to ask is also correct. Very nice. Okay, so see this exercise is giving you an idea. Like look at this. Couldn't. So when there is couldn't in the first sentence, definitely have to is not possible here. All right. Okay. So I had to ask somebody for directions. Number six, this car park is free. All right. So this car park is free. So can you just pick one word from this box? Stand, pay, make, drive. What do you think is the words which are remaining? What will you think? What do you think? Like this car park.
You don't have to pay.
You don't have to pay. Perfect. Very, very true. You don't have to pay. Misbah, correct. And you know, who is the boy that answered correctly? Okay, the car park is free. You don't have to pay. Very nice. A man was slightly injured. Abdullah. Thank you so much, Abdullah, for your active participation. A man was slightly injured in the accident. But he slightly, okay, now look at this, slightly injured, okay? A man was slightly injured in the accident. So please focus the keywords, okay? But he
He had to go to hospital.
Or if we want to make it a negative one, like, you know, for example, he didn't get major injuries. Okay. He was like fine. It was fine enough. A man was slightly injured in the accident, but he had not. All right. So remember I told
go
you
to
that
hospital.
When you have to make the negative.
You don't have to go.
Negative or past, you know, tense should be, he didn't have to. Okay. like had to,
didn't have to go.
He didn't have to go to hospital, all right? So don't have to, negative, don't have to, all right? Had to, negative, didn't have to. We will follow the past simple rule. Okay, number 8. Jen has a senior position in the company, all right? Jen has a senior position in the company. She, all right.
With she has to.
She has to. Very, very, very
she
nice.
Has to decide.
She has to make important decisions.
She has to make important decisions. Thank you so much. Perfect. All right. Number 9. The train was very full and there were no seats free. The train was very full, all right? And there was
we had
no
to stand
We had to stand all the way. Why? Because we are talking in past, right? We had to stand all the way. Perfect. When Patrick starts his new job next month, when Patrick starts his new job next month, he blank 50 miles to work every day.
He will have to.
He will have to. And the one word is also remaining that we haven't used yet. That is drive. He will have to drive 50 miles to work.
50 miles to work.
50 miles sure, to work. Right. So these are situations. You see that you know you are learning using, right? You know how to use have to for present, how to use it for he and she, like, you know, has to, and how to use it for the negatives with past, like had and didn't have to. Okay, so you are learning and you are practicing these. There's one particular structure that requires more practice. So I'll be giving you some more exercises and the screenshots in the WhatsApp group, all right? So you can do more practice. It will be great for you to acquire the language proficiency in both spoken and written, all right?
Thank you. I'm honored to be with you today for your commencement from one of the finest universities in the world. Truth be told, I never graduated from college, and this is the closest I've ever gotten to a college graduation. Today, I want to tell you 3 stories from my life. That's it. No big deal. I refuse to sign the final adoption papers.
Now just listen to this, all right? My father had never graduated from high school. Now listen what he said.
She refused to sign the final adoption papers.
All right. So what is the first word?
She refused to sign the final adoption papers.
Yeah. Who will answer me?
She will refuse to sign.
Okay, she refused. Okay. All right, actually, by the way, let me tell you that in this, in this exercise, the focused, grammar structure is using the past forms, you know, the second form of the verb. All right. So all the missing, places and the spaces, they are for using the second form of the verb or the past form of the verb. All right. So let me write, she refused to sign the
final adoption papers.
She refused. And let's check.
She only relented a few.
Okay, great. She refused. It's a great answer. All right. Now, listen to the next, sentence, what he says.
She only relented a few months later when my parents promised.
Yeah.
She only relented a few months
later. Yeah.
She only relented.
He only relented. Okay.
Only relented a few months later. Okay. My parents promised.
Okay. Those whose mics are unmute, please mute your mics. Only those who are answering. Okay. He relented. Okay. Let me write here. She relented. Right. Okay. She only relented. Okay. Sorry. She only relented. This was the right answer. What is the meaning of the word relented or relent? Can you just let me know? We have 10 minutes to go and we have to finish this. Yeah. What is the meaning? Relent. Any ideas? Hello? No ideas? Can you hear me, guys?
Ma'am, it's mean to give in.
What is the meaning of the word relent? She relented a few months later when? Alright, acha, relent means like some relent is mean to become less. Yeah, exactly.
Active keh sakte hain na.
We can say that. You know, it means that she was so adamant before, but she relented a few months later means she became less severe and she became tender, or she became, you know, considerate, right? A few months later, when? Okay, now listen, what he says, when my parents come.
That I would go to college. This was the start in my life. And 17 years later, I did go to college. But I naively chose a college.
What did he say? But I naively?
And 17 years later.
Chose the college.
All right, but I naively. All right, what is the meaning of the word naive? N-A-I-V-E, naive. Or naively, what does it mean?
And 17 years later, I did go to college. But I naively chose a college that was almost as expensive as Stanford.
All right, well done. But naively means, you know, a person who is very simple, you know, simpleton. You know, hum kehte na bahut hi bhola, bahut seedha saada, all right? So very, you can say, very, very simple, very innocent, all right? Yeah, okay? So you see that you are also getting a lot of, you know, good vocabulary in his speech, and it is a standard speech by an American Steve Jobs, a native speaker. So when you listen to what is the reason actually for incorporating these exercises for you, I want to show you a door, all right? And then you have to enter by yourself. So whenever you have time, just go and search up these motivational videos and listen to him. Not only you will be getting a lot of motivation by listening to these speeches, as well as you will get a very good exposure of vocabulary, new words, and as well as a language exposure. All right, so let's see what he has to say.
And all of my working class parents' savings were being spent on my college tuition. After 6 months, I couldn't see the value in it. I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life.
Okay, what he said.
I had no idea what I wanted to do with my life, and no idea how college.
I have no idea.
I have no idea
what I wanted to do.
Okay, very good. I had no idea. Let us write what I wanted to do. Okay, to do is already written. Okay, what I wanted. Just tell. Okay, well done. Good. This is correct. What I wanted to do with my life. Listen.
Yeah, how college was going to help me figure it out. And here I was, spending all the money my parents had saved their entire life. So I decided to drop out and trust that it would all work out. Okay.
So I decided.
What did he say?
I decided to drop out
and trust that it would all work out okay.
Oh, very good.
It was
very nice. All right. So I decided to drop out. All right. Ariba, Asan, thank you so much because you are writing your answers in the chat box. Thank you so much. So I decided to drop out and trust that it would all work out. Okay. Now, listen.
Pretty scary at the time, but looking back, it was one of the best decisions I ever made. The minute I dropped out, I could stop taking the required classes.
Yeah. What did he say?
The minute I dropped out, I could stop taking the required classes.
Good. The minute I dropped out, I could stop taking the required classes that didn't interest me. Remember, I told you that Steve Jobs' biography, his life history, is very, very inspirational. Okay. So he is a graduate, you know, he is a college dropout. He couldn't complete his graduation. So he is sharing his experience of, his college life, that how he was not interested in the subjects. And then what did he do later? Just listen.
That didn't interest me and begin dropping in on the ones that looked far more interesting.
What did he say? And begin dropping in ones. Okay. Any ideas?
Look far interesting.
Okay.
Me, and begin dropping in on the ones that looked far more interesting.
All right, so me, that, that's right.
And
that
begin
looked,
dropping in on the ones that looked far more interesting.
That looked.
It was.
Okay. Oh, well done. Okay, that looked far more interesting. Okay.
It wasn't all romantic. I didn't have a dorm room, so I slept on the floor in friends' rooms. I returned coke bottle room, so I slept on the floor in friends' rooms.
Okay, what I did returned you say? Mm-hmm. I didn't have a dorm room, so I
returned.
All right. So listen again.
Room, so I slept on the floor in friends' rooms. I returned.
What is he saying? That I didn't have a dorm room, so I slept. All right. Who has written Ariba Iqbal? Ariba, this is
room. So I slept on the floor in friends' rooms. I returned coke bottles.
Okay. So you see that in this exercise, you are going to have the you know, the idea of regular and irregular, both the kinds of the forms of words, right? There are, you know, the irregular forms of the verbs, which three forms are different, and regular, which can be you know, made past and past participle with the addition of D and ED. All right. So you see that this is an amazing exercise for your language improvement. We have 3 minutes to go, so I would just finish it after this one, and then I'll have some last words with you before ending the session. Okay? Okay. Now, number 9.
Ma'am?
Yeah, please.
I returned coke bottles.
Yeah.
For
hello. Yeah. Who? Yeah, please ask.
Ma'am, what do you mean by dorm room? Last room or
I didn't have
something
a,
else?
No, I didn't have a dorm room means, you know, dormitory. Aapne suna hoga. Dormitory is a word. So when the college students, they are staying at the hostel or, you know, in the dormitory. So they have a room, but he didn't have, okay? So that is why he had to sleep on the floor in the friend's room, because he did not have his own room, right? And as he was saying that he had some, you know, in the earlier speech that he had financial issues, his parents couldn't pay, you know, his fee, or he did not want even to pay the fee because he thought that he wasn't learning anything, and his classes did not interest him. All right, so that is why he dropped the college and he started sitting in the classes which were of his interest. So, okay, now let's go ahead.
I returned coke bottles for the 5 cent deposits to buy food with.
Okay, now see.
I returned coke bottles for the 5 cent deposits to buy.
Yeah, what did he say? I returned. What did? What is the word?
I returned coke bottles for 5 cent deposits to buy food with.
Okay, you see that how much, you know.
I returned coke bottles for the 5 cent deposits to buy food with.
I
and I would
returned.
Walk the.
All right, now check. I returned coke bottles for 5 cents deposits to buy food with, and I would walk the 7 miles across town every Sunday night to get one good meal a week at the Hare Krishna temple. Oh my God! See how inspirational his life is. That when he was at the college, he didn't have money to even buy food, and he only had to travel, and had to walk actually 7 miles across town every Sunday night to get one good meal a week. You know, can you imagine this type of, you know, struggling life? We always are, you know, you can say that we always are ungrateful for whatever we have, and still we are not taking our life seriously and our aims and ambitions and the goals that we have set in our life, or if we haven't set, we should set. So I would request you to please go and watch his video, because time is running. We have hardly 1 minute. Okay. All right. So we have hardly 1 minute. I would request you to go and watch his video, and I hope that you will